You're so noisy. Renod? He's knocking stuff over. Hi. Nice hat. You have an even tone?
You are not fit to stand before me! Be gone, Wastrel!
Be gone. Why am I not fit? What's with the hat?
The hat? The hat? You dare refer to it as a hat?
Well, that's what it is.
This bumpkin is a Kalovian fur elm. They were all the rage back in the Third Era, though their popularity has since waned. But I, the illustrious Renod Even-Toned, am spearheading their revival. Not only am I a pioneer of music, I am also a pioneer of fine fashions. Soon, when you see all and sundry walking around sporting them, you'll know, in the back of your mind, that Renod Even-Toned was there first.
This guy's a bard? How the hell does he sing? I can't imagine his singing voice. I see.
Indeed you do. Gaze upon the visage of my third hero, Kalovian Fur Elm, for its originality is sadly fleeting.
So, you're a bard?
I am the most illustrious bard in the entirety of Tamriel. I promise you that.
It's kind of boss.
Much better than any of the bumpkins from the Bard's College. That I graduated to, of course.
You graduated from the Bard's College in Skyrim?
Of course I did. What, you think Renod Even-Toned, a master bard and true artist, would be rejected from the Bard's College? Of course not.
They're going to be below you. You seem very confident about your ability.
Of course I am. A true Nord knows that boasting is appropriate when it is called for. And Renod Even-Toned knows this well. Or are you insulting my ability, bumpkin? Don't tempt me.
You don't want to call me a bumpkin. Tempt you to do what exactly?
To clunk you over the head with
what?
My flute or my lute or bludgeon you with my fiddle.
Oh, I'll slice you up, baby.
I know. I will travel to Daggerfall, grab one of those fancy Breton knobs and spank you with it.
I beg your pardon.
Ooh, or I could slam you with a tambourine so vigorously that every Bruma citizen could hear it. That would make you the joke of the day. Oh, look, there goes the tambourine man.
Play a song for me.
Tambourine woman just doesn't have the same ring to it. Tambourine lady, maybe? How's that sound, Bissin' Rube?
I beg your pardon. I'll roast you with a fireball. I'm just gonna go up here now. Ooh, Lorcan the Charlatan. Hi. Someone drew a sword. Oh.
Halt! Your reckless disregard for the law has come to an end. You're under arrest.
I am? What did I do? Because I came in here? My bounty is 5... That's like... below petty change, so here.
Let's get this straightened out. Your stolen goods are going back to their rightful owners.
Ah!
And you're coming with me.
I didn't do nothing. Alright. Where's my stuff? I still have my weapons, right? Nightingale blade. Where's my, dragon bolt?
Excuse me, sorry to bother. I don't suppose you've seen any priceless Akaviri heirlooms gallivanting around Bruma, have you?
Akaviri heirlooms? I'm sorry, what?
Akaviri heirlooms. Priceless Akaviri heirlooms. Seen any?
No heirlooms, sorry.
As I suspected. Sorry to bother you, citizen. Just, let me know if any do crop up, yeah? Thanks.
Yeah. What's all this about Akaviri heirlooms?
A whole lot of uproar about nothing, that's what. The Count's been nagging my life and soul out about the damn things. You see, the Carvanes have a sort of family tradition. They've acquired a taste for Akaviri artifacts, constantly collecting more and more. Been going on for centuries now. Well, it turns out poor old Count Desilus, Count Carvane,
which one?
Isn't too happy that his collection's been stolen.
Which count is it? Near tone, though. Tensions between you and the count? And what's with the two different names?
No, not tensions as such, just... I'm tired. I've had 4 sleepless nights in a row. The Count's talking my ear off about these artifacts, and it's stopping me from tending to more important issues. Not that I'm disloyal to Count Carvane, of course. I've never had reason to dislike our ruler. Better him than some of the other counts and countesses in the province.
You mentioned more important issues?
Yes, this damned artifact business doesn't affect anyone except the Count. While I'm out chasing after shiny baubles, people are getting killed by bandits and waylaid on the road. I mean, we've got Thorina's cutters roaming the Geralds and harrying travelers for Stendar's sake.
Yeah, who are they?
And I'm wandering Bruma after trinkets, like some lost paint horse looking for its master.
Yeah, I'm wondering who they were. We got attacked by them in the second episode, I believe. Could you use some help searching for them?
Well, that's... Oh, who am I kidding? Absolutely. This is driving me crazy. Just bring them back to me when you found them, and I'll be extremely appreciative. And I mean extremely appreciative. Seriously. I feel like offing myself right about now.
Seriously, I feel like offing myself right about now. Oh, that's freaking hilarious. What exactly was stolen?
Akaviri artifacts. I don't know anything more specific than that.
Oh, great.
Rignar and the Count both told me, but honestly, it flew in one ear and out the other. If you want to know exactly what artifacts to keep your eyes peeled for, talk to Rignar. I'm sure he can help you more there.
When and how were the artifacts stolen?
I'm not too sure on the details of that, to be honest. Rignar, the castle steward, was the first one who noticed them missing. It'd be worth speaking to him, if you think that's interesting evidence to dig up.
Why would the thief want the artifacts? For monetary value or for some other reason?
Almost definitely the resale value. Akaviri artifacts are very often one of a kind. And they can fetch a very high price to the right buyers. Someone possessing those artifacts could find themselves becoming very wealthy very quickly. I suspect that's the motive here.
The real challenge would be finding a merchant that has enough money. Especially around here. How did the thief even get inside the castle?
I have no idea how they'd manage that, honestly. Either adept stealth or good luck. Probably a bit of both.
Do you have any suspects?
Not in particular. Then again, the lowlives of Bruma don't exactly hide themselves all that well. The shadier tavern in town, the Restful Watchman, full of thieves, bandits, thugs, and other miscreants.
Oh, they are, huh?
Might be a decent place to start your search.
Okay, I know where that is. What's it like being Bruma's guard captain?
It's tough. On one side, you've got criminals, the kind that like to hide behind law and policy to wriggle out of justice. On the other, you've got politics, constantly meddling in our affairs as everyone walks on eggshells. And here I am in the center, just trying to make things work for the people. Sometimes I wish I'd stayed down in the Imperial City.
You're from the Imperial City?
Yep, me and my family. Wife and children are still there, in fact. Left because the place is swarming with people. Hard to find any work. Came up here, couldn't find much work either. Joined the guard on a whim. Saw a lot, rose to the ranks. And now I'm guard captain. Funny how things work out. I try to take my duties seriously. And send as much as I can back to my loved ones.
Do politics often get in the way of your work?
More than you might think. Between the Count, the White Gold Concordat, and all the other treaties, the rules are constantly changing. All I want to do is protect these people, jail criminals, earn my keep. Then the damned wind changes, and with it, the law. And then, what do you know, I'm supposed to jail this group, and that group, and the other group. And for what? For politics. Despite it all, though, I wouldn't trade this job for the world. It's rewarding, fulfilling, and at least it lets me provide for myself and my family.
So Bruma has a problem with criminals, huh?
Well, I don't know if I'd go that far. We have it fairly okay compared to some other parts of the province. The problem is that the criminals here aren't driven to it out of desperation. They just want the coin, to get rich. They know how to game the system. Except Doctocto. He's... well, never mind. I've probably told you too much.
Doctocto? Go on, you can tell me.
You're right. Well, listen.
That's right.
Doctocto's a thief. Likes to call himself a cat burglar. Funny Khajiit sense of humor.
It is.
But it's funny. He steals from those who don't deserve what they have. Like, say, other thieves or power-mad politicians.
Okay, so it's a Robin Hood.
And he sells the stuff. With a discount for those who truly need it, no less. I don't understand that cat. But I can't really complain. As thieves go, he's one of the better ones. But he currently has charges leveled against him from Cetus, the owner of Icewind Traders. So that's that.
Speak to Doctocto about charges against him. Okay, so he's kind of like a Robin Hood, only he still wants some profit for himself.
Goodbye.
Okay, I need my stolen things back. I suppose it's down here in the dungeons? I suppose I've just been let out of this place? Oh god, the dog's pushing me back out. God damn it. Ugh. Have a seat.
What is it?
Can I tell this dog to...
You must have a feather-light foot and one keen eye to risk wearing such light armor. Not to mention some real stones.
Oh, thanks. Don't let my dog get in your way. I have these books.
Heard there were beasts around. Be careful, traveler.
Yeah, we've got a beast right here. I'm waiting to see if she'll leave the room. It's been a while since I've done this. Broken. Wait. Oh, God. Bounty, but she didn't go after me. It's all my stolen stuff, most of it from Skyrim. Dog, I have to leave.
I'm tempted to ask you to warm me up with some of your fire magic. Don't do it, though. Then I'd have to arrest you.
Well, good, because I got a bounty on me as well. I can't just pay my bounty without you guys taking my stuff.
Civilian?
The barracks? They're not going after me, though, so maybe I can just talk to these guys.
Those are dexterous hands. Bet you've picked a few locks in your day. Well, don't get any ideas around here.
Oh, I talked to him.
Watch your back outside the city walls. We can't be charging to your aid if a timber wolf catches your scent.
I killed a few. Dexterous hands, huh? Oh god, this dog.
Zombies tend to haunt caves. Be careful if you decide to go treasure hunting.
I like killing zombies. These are all just Bruma guards.
I may serve Count Carvane, but I take commands from the guard captain.
Well, good for you. Don't mind my dog, he's... Oh my god. It's not my dog. So, where are we? Castle Bruma Great Hall. Back out to Cyrodiil. There's a dungeon. Alright. Hi.
Hello.
Far as far?
What is it?
What do you do here?
Clean, mostly. I do all the work that nobody else wants to. I don't mind it, really. Especially since that means I get to work around my friend Irma. Thanks for asking.
You have a very deep voice.
Farewell.
Farewell. God, more books. Oh, I need to read that one. Oh, volume 1 and 2, Scripture of St. Martin. Need to get rid of the dog so I can steal things without... Castle Bruma, Lord's Manor. These museum pamphlets are all over the place. Nightfall?
For County Bruma.
What's for County Bruma? Guest wing? Oh, that's a torch. Great Hall. Service Hall. Lord's Manor.
I see by your walk, your demeanor. You're a sneak. Let's just hope you're not also a thief.
Let's also hope I don't ram my sword up your buttocks. Affana Eddici.
Hello. I am Affana Eddici. I'm part of the Bruma Court. Rather high ranking in it, too.
Oh, well, good for you.
Anyway, is there anything you needed?
Do you know of any nobles that hired mercenaries recently?
Let me think. There was one raid Simund organized, last I remember. Never mentioned it to me. Always been a quiet fellow. But I saw it in his journal.
What are you looking at his journal? You were reading his journal?
Well, yes. He's one of those mysterious men, you know?
Great shadow.
Just has an aura about him. Piques a lady's interest.
Oh,
does it? You can't blame me for peeking in his journal, I hope.
I can't?
We all have our vices.
Do you remember when this raid was?
No, truth told. Though I imagine you could just check Simmons' journal if you wanted to do that. I obviously couldn't endorse such behavior, though. Goes without saying, I suppose.
You'd do it yourself. Where would I find Simmons' journal?
In his quarters, of course. Though you may need a key to get inside.
I'm sure you have that. Something makes me think you have that key.
Well, maybe I do. Yeah, I'm a terrible liar. Okay, I have one. But I obviously couldn't give it to you now, could I? Unless...
Why not?
You could always do me a favor.
Oh? What kind of a favor?
Here's what we'll do. I'll give you the key to Simmons' quarters, and you can do whatever you wish.
Oh, yeah?
But in return, you have to leave this note in his drawer. No need to read it. It's sentimental.
I'm gonna read it. I'll do it. Now hand over the key.
Oh, fantastic. Here you go. I eagerly await your return.
I'll show you now. Optional. You know I'm gonna read it. Alfana's letter to Simund. Dear Simund, I have been smitten with you since the very moment I first laid my unworthy eyes upon you. You possess an air of mystery, so palpable and yet so vague. I simply want to reach out and touch it, to unravel it, yet its vagaries continue to perplex me. If you wish to grant me the rare pleasure of unraveling your mystery, meet me in my quarters at 9 next Turdas night. I'm sure it'll be an unforgettable experience for both of us. Your inquisitive girl, Affana. This is hilarious. I don't suppose I can talk to her about this letter?
Hmm?
What do you do here in Castle Bruma, anyway?
Do? Oh,
yeah, do.
Well, I suppose I don't really do anything in particular. I mean, I help out the Count when needed, of course.
Hmm.
My father owned land outside of Bruma, and after some lucrative business with the Carvanes, became well-respected. I inherited what he owned when he passed, and, well, here I am. Oh, but I do love conversations like this. Feel
you
free
do?
To come back and chat about it again sometime.
Must be nice.
Farewell.
All the rising threat books. Wolf Queen. What's this? The Artist's Guide to Painting, Volume 1. I need to read these books. Affirmation of Titus Mead. I'm not sure. I might have read it. Well, she's actually got ice rate teeth and stuff. Sleep well.
Respect the law. Respect yourself.
Oh. Thus, I am the law. I am the law. That now requires a key. What's this? Huh. This is a really big castle. And again, I guess most castles are big. Rignar?
I'm the Count's steward here in Bruma. If there is anything you need, I'll try my best to help you.
His voice sounds very familiar. The other guy. The cleaner. Oh god, that must be the dog. You're the steward in Castle Bruma?
Indeed I am. I handle the day-to-day business of the county on behalf of the Count, the fair and honorable Desilus Carvane.
Hmm. Some small talk first. Tell me about County Bruma.
County Bruma is the jewel of Cyrodiil. Though the mountains may be frosty, the hearts of our people are as warm as the brightest hearth. Of course, that's not to say that she's perfect. As with any county, we have our fair share of vicious wildlife and shameless brigands. But we don't let that put a dampener on things. That's the Nord way, after all. And Bruma's as Nordic as she is Imperial.
Do you know of any nobles that hired mercenaries for a bandit raid last year?
An interesting question. We keep records of expenses from members of the Bruma court, especially the times it's coming out of our treasury.
Sure.
However, we don't give this kind of information out to anyone who so much as asks. Why do you want to know?
Just give me the... I'm investigating a kidnapping on suspicions of foul play.
Truly? I see an honest glint in your eye. I think you are telling the truth.
Well, that was easy.
Well then, I will get you any information I can from the records.
Excellent.
One moment while I go check them. You just wait around here.
Okay. I go sleep next to your wife here? Oh wait, that's... Oh. That's not his wife.
Well, I've checked the records.
That was
quick.
There
was one account of Affana Eddici hiring some mercenaries for a job similar to your description last year.
I just talked to her.
She spends a lot of time around the castle. You can go speak to her if you wish. Out of memory, there was another who hired some mercenaries for a bandit raid last year too. It was, Simund Gautierre.
Oh.
Yeah, that's the one.
I saw his mansion.
Not too sure on the details. I'm going off of memory here, since his mission wasn't recorded in the books. Strange, that. We usually keep thorough records. Well, anyway, I hope I was of some help, but that's all I know, and all the books know. Best of luck with your investigation.
Well, thank you.
Can I help you?
Looking for bounties? Got any leads?
A group of bandits in the county are growing bolder and are becoming a menace. The count has put a bounty on their heads. Here, take a look at the warrant.
Kill the bandit ringleader of Capstone Cave, okay. And Adius hired me. Let's talk about the stolen artifacts.
So the guard captain's actually looking into it.
Mm-hmm.
Excellent. Can't have the Carvane artifact collection lost to some random burglar.
All right, a long conversation. What artifacts exactly are missing?
Some amulets, some rings, a katana, all of Akaviri design. Priceless relics. Very valuable and very well loved by the Count.
Did you see the theft itself? What happened?
I didn't know. I was just doing the rounds here in the castle. I was about to go to bed for the night when I noticed something.
Very similar to now.
Normally there's a little glint in the corner of my eye. The light bouncing off of one of the Akaviri amulets. But this time, nothing. I went to investigate, and the artifacts were gone.
Yep.
I'm sorry I can't be of more use.
Alright, well I'm done questioning you for now. Is that what I was doing?
Best of luck with your investigation.
Is he a suspect? I thought I was just getting more information. Now I'm wondering
what
if
is it?
If he might be a suspect. Oh, okay. You've got some powers there.
What is it?
Nothing, apparently.
See you.
You two go back to what you were doing. Wouldn't want to interrupt. To wake up all these sleeping people. Oh, Simund Gautierre! You have a mansion in the middle of the mountains, don't you?
Hmm?